Good morning, everyone. My name is Erica Levy, and I am a yoga and a barre instructor at Cascade Athletic Clubs in Gresham and Fisher's Landing. This is Barre for Active Aging, but it's also such a great class for introduction to barre. So let me just introduce what is barre. Barre is a fusion of ballet, Pilates, yoga, and strength training. So it's a really great workout because it's low impact, but it's high energy. And I have been teaching on Tuesdays and Thursdays at Cascade Athletic Clubs in Gresham, and most of my class are active agers. And so I decided to look more into what exercises would be good for them going into the next phase that they're growing into. And also, I have all kinds of different things going on in my body. I'm getting older, I'm 43. I have a 5 and a 7-year-old, and I'm constantly bending and twisting in all directions, chasing after them. So what I love about barre is that it's functional fitness. It is preparing your body for those everyday activities of loading the dishes or dishwasher, hunched over washing dishes, folding laundry, bending over and picking up toys, walking up the stairs. So I feel like I have definitely toned and strengthened, especially my lower body, which supports my spine. And I've had a lot less back pain since I have started doing barre because I have that strength and stability. So this is a great workout. So I'm just gonna say good morning. Oh, can you hear me? I'm sorry, some people were saying they can't hear. So I just wanna make sure you guys, okay, great. Julie says it's good. So I think we'll just go ahead and jump in just a moment. What else did I want to tell you? Okay, props. So you can grab a chair, so that we will use as a barre. And then also, if you want to use a yoga mat, you can grab one. We don't necessarily need one. I'm not even sure I'll use mine today. Maybe at the end for core. I also have a couple lightweights here. So I'm going to be using 3-pound weights today and a squishy ball if you have one. When we get into the sections where I will be using a ball, you don't need one. You can just keep your hands, just use your hands. But it's nice when you have a ball to have that positioning just there for you. But all right, we're just going to jump in. Good morning, Diane, Deborah, Julie. Thanks for hopping on here. Morgan, oh good, I'm glad that we have some newbies on here. This is a super fun workout. I absolutely love it, and I think you're gonna have a lot of fun too. So, without much further ado, let's get to it. I'm gonna put my equipment off to the side and my chair off to the side so we don't need, because we don't need it for the first song. Okay. All right. I've got my blinds open and the sunlight kind of coming and going, so hopefully you can see me okay. All right. It always disconnects from my speaker. All right. So we're just gonna start nice and easy, all 10 toes pointing forward. Hands can be just up here. We're just gonna do a little bend, all right? Not moving the hips much, just bending the knees. Now open your toes out to the side and bend. Arms can be out to the side. Come back to center. Two more, open to the side. So first position. I'm gonna turn it up louder here. Keep going. Center. Out. Center. Hands come down. Tuck your tailbone and round. Low back. Stretch and push. Cat cow just in the lumbar spine here. Stretch. Inhale. Other hand reaches back, other way. hand. Now open, bend. Now genie arms. Releve onto the toes. Up and down. Lift and lower. Watch my change. 4, 3, 2, 1. Toe, front of the foot, stretch. Come back to the ball of the foot, press the heel down. Other foot, lift. Front of the foot, stretch. Ball of the foot, heel down. Now to tempo. Ball of the foot, turn it over, press down. Last one. Back to the squat. Open up to first position. Back to the center. 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold the squat. You got it. All right, so warming up the upper body now. Go ahead and grab your, oh wait, sorry, I have one more. I lied before we grab the chair. All right, come back. Actually, we're going to, sorry about that. I learned this routine in a week while I'm homeschooling a 5 and 7 year old, so forgive me. All right, so I'm gonna bring the chair near just to have if I need it for balance for this. All right. Here we go. All right, so we're going to start in releve where we left off on the heels. All right, in first position with the heels together, bend the knees, press the heels down, and lift up to straight. Releve, bend, straight. Releve, bend, press, straighten. You got it. Lift, bend, heels down, straighten, lift, bend. Good. Oh yeah, position. We'll get there. Warming it up. All right. You can kind of groove with it, but then widen the stance. Right arm reaches across. We're going to switch the left arm. Reach. Bicep curls here. Just down touch with the bicep curl. Hamstrings. Kick your heels. Squeeze it up. You got it. Now, lifting the knees. Add a rotation. Now march it. March your feet together. Back, front, back, front, back, front, back, front. Now keep it back with the heel down. Reach, keep that heel down as you reach forward and pull back. Two more. Hold here. Now tricep press and bend the knees. So calf lengthening. Give me two more. Step together. All right, back in front. Here we go again. Other foot. Back, front, back, Heel down, toe point forward, reach. And pull. Normally we would be having our forearms on the bar. What I love about using the chair is that you get just as much intensity, but you bring the floor up to you. So I'm gonna try to do this so you can see me here. All right, so I'm gonna bring my forearms to the bar, to the chair. Make sure that your chair is either super heavy like mine, or that you lean your chair up against a wall or a table so that it's not moving around a lot. All right. Come into your plank pose, shoulders are directly over elbows. Shift your hips high to a modified down dog. Wave back forward and adjust. Okay? Down dog. Wave forward. You should be in a perfect plank pose now. Alright, knee to chest, right knee. Slow. Left knee. Right. And left. Stick with it slow or tempo. Give me eight. Yes. Four. Three. Two. One. Diagonal across the body. Slow for four. And you can stick with slow. Or you can speed it up here. For eight. Eight. Seven. Six. Four.
Upper body is feeling good. All right. Okay, so I'm gonna put the chair to the side again here. And we're gonna get into more upper body, so please grab your light weights. All right, starting with biceps.
Someone like you, someone like you.
Oh,
I want you to know me. I want you to show me.
All right, two. Right, two, left. And then together for four. Four. Just a small bend in the knees, not too much. Repeat the right. Two left. Together. Really squeeze that bicep up. Full range of motion here. Give me eight more. Eight. Keep breathing. Stay connected to your breath the whole time. Alright, step wide. Lunge side to side. Bring your left hand to your hip. We're just going to use the twist with a rotation on the right. Short lever. Now a little bit longer. Keep your elbow in, but we're going to kind of wave a little bit longer lever here. Get that rotation in the shoulder. Get it warmed up. Longer lever. Maybe a little bit slower here. Hips are going a little bit wider. Adding on here. We're going to go back and forth and all the way around. All the way around. Then back, front, all the way around. Back to the front, all the way around. One more. Good. All right, other hand. Left side first with a short lever. Rotate and bring it in. Really engage your core here. All right, a little bit bigger with the movement. Flow. You can get dancing with it, but I still want you to maintain control of your body. All right, longer levers. This feels so good on the shoulder. All right, are you ready to slow it down? Slow. Feeling warm? Okay, good. That's great. Okay, so let's see. We're going to keep our weights and we're going to roll right into the next one here. Grab a sip of water really quick if you need one. Okay, we're going to move into back, triceps, pelvic floor, and core. What I wanted to say was have your ball nearby, please. That's what I wanted to say. Okay, so I'm going to have my ball nearby. I also have my chair nearby just in case I need it, so I'm side facing it. Okay, here we go.
I see what you're with.
Oh, let me just say, we're gonna set up in a lunge. I'm more of a warrior one, because I am a yogi, so more than a lunge, because a lunge, I would have my heel off of the ground, typically, and I want your heel on the ground. And you can point your toes forward as much as possible, but you still just want your knee pointing in the same direction as your toes, and a slight bend in that front leg. You're gonna bring your left hand to your upper leg, and you're gonna place both weights in your right hand. We're gonna start with a row, coming from the front, pulling the elbow back, and I want you to rotate and really look over your shoulder every time we rotate. Okay, so even if I'm facing forward talking to you, you're gonna be looking over your shoulder.
There's nothing beneath it. Forgive me for staring. Forgive me for breathing. We might not know why. We might not know how. But maybe tonight we're beautiful now.
You got it. Down in front of you, press back.
We'll open the clouds, cause baby tonight, we're beautiful now, we're beautiful.
Transfer the weight to the left hand, come back into that lunge pose, reach and pull, here we go, pull, pull, pull. Does everyone feel good? All right. We're doing awesome with timing. I'm working up a sweat. So like I said, low impact does not mean low intensity. It is a misnomer, right? You can still get quite an amazing workout and being safe with your body and doing exercises that are helping you build strength, right? Okay, so good. Okay, good, thumbs up. All right, so now, where are we? I'm gonna put down the weights in the ball. We don't need that for this. Whew, take a deep breath in. Let it go, one more. Let it go. All right, working into some more ballet movements here. We're gonna do a tendu. I never really took ballet in school, but I've done dance fitness literally almost my whole life. But point, heel to the front, point, heel to the back. do a brush. Brush. Little brush. 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 Now a little bit more. Higher. Full range of motion, whatever that is for you.
Side leg lift. You got it.
workout for 3 days straight and my obliques are killing me. So I'm sure you did better than I did on that. All right, grab a quick sip of water. We're gonna come down for core. Hi, Danny. All right, thanks for joining when I'm already nice and sweaty. All right, we're gonna do some core and then we'll cool down, all right? So if you wanna roll out your mat, you can grab it and roll it out, have your ball. If you have one, if not, it's totally fine. Like I said, all right. I'm gonna come down to the floor. Make sure y'all can see me okay. All right, so it'll get a little tricky here. All right. I hope you guys are having a good time working out with me. Oh, thank you, Deborah. Yeah, so Barre Babes is an amazing program that Cascade Athletic Club just introduced in January. And on the Barre Babes website, there's a whole section for Barre for active aging. And I just skimmed the tip of the iceberg with it. So I've been super excited to learn more myself. And if you like it, I would really like to be doing this on Tuesdays and Thursdays in Gresham, because I think it's really the perfect fit for my regulars that come and the demographic that usually come to my classes at that time. Okay, so give me your feedback for sure and give feedback to the club for sure. Whew. All right, let's get core. Core is gonna be nice and slow. Oh, it disconnected from my speaker, of course. Talking too much. All right, earthquake pose. Earthquake, why is it called earthquake? Well, because if you have the ball tucked under your sacrum, or if you just lean back until you start feeling that shake, that's earthquake pose. Arms just are out in front. You're gonna reach up and lean back. Like honey, slow like honey. Twist the knee, foot up, and rotate. stretch up and around the rib cage.
Living in perfect, like it's so right.
Press up to the sky. Point and flex.
Treat it like freedom. Do you still believe me? You close your eyes.
Circle it.
We've been running circles so long.
Circle other direction.
The answers bring more questions. The rise turns to wrong.
Bend your left knee. Plant your foot. Cross your ankle over your knees. Reach between the legs. Pull back toward your base.
Show me our differences. I show you.
Flex your toes back. Breathe into those glutes. You worked it hard.
Maybe we're blind because it feels like we're living in a shadow.
Slowly release. Switch legs. Left knee comes up and around the ribcage. Pull it into the armpit.
And we slowly get frozen.
Heel to the ceiling. Point and flex.
To compromise. Changing
circles.
We keep our hearts open. If you can't feel the weight, then we won't survive.
Circle the other direction.
Because we've been running circles so long.
Bend your knee. Cross it over your legs. Cross ankle over knee. Pull back on the back leg. Really. Press them into the elbow and press your elbow into the thigh to get a little bit deeper here.
Show me our differences.
Nice big breath. Feedback. Thank you so much for joining me today, and thanks for having some grace with me on the imperfections. Perfectly imperfect class, but I really miss being with you all. I miss this community. I love this workout, and I really hope that we get some really good feedback about it, because I'd like to continue working with active agers, and I'm moving into that stage of my life not so soon. I'm 43 years old, as I may have mentioned earlier, and I think it just feels so good in my body, and I still get so many of the same benefits without hurting myself or feeling like I'm overexerting myself. So I think it's a really great, safe, high-intensity, low-impact workout. Oh, thank you, Nancy, so much for joining us. Deborah, oh, I'm so glad you joined. Morgan, I don't know if Chris is on here, but if you're watching this on demand, I miss you so much. All my regulars, Teresa, if you're watching, I hope all my regulars are watching. And yeah, and Lori, I hope you were able to join. Diane, thank you so much, everybody. Take care. Have a wonderful rest of your weekend. Mwah. Stay safe out there.